What's the difference between the EJ205 and the EJ207, even in Japan? Today, we're gonna go ahead and answer that question for you guys, so check it out. Good afternoon from Okinawa, Japan, home of OkiSubies. Today, we're gonna answer a question that we get a lot from our customers. Out here, a lot of the guys are getting GC8s because they're importable now back to the States. The thing with GC8s are the engines are pretty old. There's old sensors, discontinued parts on the engine, not tunable. So a popular thing that we do out here is the merges, right? So we are actually taking a EJ205, 207, sometimes even newer model engine and putting it into the GC8. When we give them the two prices, EJ205 or 207, WRX engine or STI engine, the first question is always, what's the difference between the EJ205 and the 207? So today, we're gonna go ahead and try to break down as much as we can without getting too crazy detailed. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna start with the block, because this is really where the biggest difference is when it comes to the structural aspect of the cylinder walls. So you have what, if you've heard of it before, right? You have the open deck and the semi-closed deck. And the difference is, as you can see right here, there is no support on the sides. Versus the EJ207s have the extra support. When you close deck it, it's an aftermarket setup where you have to get a really early GC8 or legacy block, but this is all more enclosed in, and but there's not very many, there's no factory options when you're doing it in a newer motor. The version 10 motors also, like if you talk about like GRB, VAB, they're thicker. Cylinder walls all the way around this part right here, it's so thick that this pretty much gets thinner. It goes all the way around. But anyways, check out another video that we have. I think it was Robin's 2.1 liter. We show that in his GRB. But EJ205, 207, first thing right here is the semi-closed deck versus open deck. Going farther in on the inside, the next is the rods. So this is a EJ205 rod. This is an EJ207 rod. As you can see, the EJ207 is beefier, and they are bolts like this versus the studs that you see with just a nut on the bottom. Oftentimes, when we see guys pushing power inside the EJ205 and pushing the limits on those, we see rods fail first. So we figured that this is a pretty important thing to point out. There's some difference between the pistons, but I don't want to get too much into the detail with that, because like the version 7 is a forged piston and then version 8 and up is not. I guess that I just did it. That's it. Another difference, injector size. So you have the blue versus pinks, 565, and these are like, I don't know, like 4-6 something. I can't remember what it is, but if you do any type of upgrades to the turbos, we recommend that you put pinks inside of an EJ205 at least when you're doing like an IHI setup when it comes to the turbos. And speaking of turbos, that is actually one of when it comes to the performance, that's a huge difference. As you can see here, this is the TD04, the smaller turbo. This is a VF30 from a Bug Eye STI. I chose the Bug Eye STI one specifically because they're both single scroll. Blob eye and up in Japan, we have the twin scroll setup, so even it looks a lot different. But you can see that the compressor housing is different, and then the exhaust housing also. This one spools up quickly, but it's like a 3,000 to 4,500 RPM range when it comes to your power. This VF30s are like kind of like a little mini 16G. They do a lot better up top than the TD04 setups. So that's the turbo side. When it comes to the heads, I'm not going to get too detailed in that. They're better flowing when it comes to the version 8 or version 7 and up. So the EJ207s have better flowing. They also rev to 8,000 RPMs versus the EJ205s. They rev to 7.5, less than the EJ207s, right? So another thing is, if you've ever heard of TGVs or TGV deletes, just think of the intake manifold, right? Boxer engine. So we're going like this across. STIs do not have TGVs versus the WRXs have TGVs, which are little butterfly flaps that go inside here. And there is not a huge amount, but there's definitely more restriction when it comes to that. And more importantly, something that can fail. So if you have a WRX, we do a lot of those TGV deletes just simply because of that. And then you have, going outside the engine, the intercoolers. The WRX intercooler is smaller than the STI intercooler. So just to kind of quickly recap, you have the semi-closed deck versus open. The rods are definitely different. You have the turbo, injector sides, heads are better flowing. The cool thing about EJ205 to 207 is the casting of the heads in Japan are the same. They both have big ports. They both have AVCS. So performance-wise, it's actually really nice. We often take these injectors and an STI turbo, put it on the EJ205 and tune it, and they actually perform really, really well. One of these days, we want to try to rev it out to 8,000 RPM to see how long it lasts, because the small turbo not being able to breathe on the TD04 may be also another reason why they don't rev it out to 8,000 RPMs, because we see that the heads are very, very similar. So we'll see. But yeah, hopefully this helps. We plan on just linking this to the customers, just sending them this link if they want to know what's the difference between. So, but if you have any other questions, or if you have any other inputs on differences that we missed, we probably did, put them in the comments, and that way, you know, our customers or any other people who want to know the difference, we'll be able to read the comments and get those too. So thanks for checking it out. Have a nice day.